Well, I was an undergrad at York University and studying psychology. I started working with a professor of mine. And at one point he said to me, the neat thing about being a researcher is we're all curious. We're curious as children. We've got lots of questions, want to know why the sky is blue, why the rain falls, all sorts of things. He said, as a researcher, you develop the skills and the ability to answer the questions that you've got that are interesting to you and to other people. I realized that there are certain things that psychologists really need to know about. And as a clinician, one thing you really do have to understand is how to assess suicide risk and how to work with people who are suicidal. And one of the things that, compared to our colleagues in the States, we are farther behind in is focusing on older adult psychology and older adult mental health. And recognizing that this was a group at risk, especially older men have the highest risk in the world, I thought, this isn't right. We've got to do something about it. And I don't buy the argument that just because you might have less time left in your life, you shouldn't have rich, full, and enjoyable time. Well, one of the things that we knew it would be a bit of a challenge is recruiting men in their 60s or now late 50s into a group run by a psychologist, talking about your feelings and your experiences. But, and my contention from the start was, when they're there, when they're in the room, they'll talk, they'll share, they'll talk about their experiences and their feelings and their relationships, they'll support one another, they'll learn from each other and benefit, and they have. My research has really gone from much more theoretical to the clinically applied to really trying to have a bigger impact on our communities and on our healthcare system. And the hope is if we're able to do that, then there's something that we might be able to do to enhance access to mental health care services, to improve health and well-being, and hopefully eventually to start reducing the suicide rate.